Wouldn't it be great if your spouse came with an instruction manual, please? Well, in his new book, Cover Him, former Super Bowl champion, Pastor Roderick Hairston, speaks to women to help us care for the hidden needs, thoughts, and feelings of the man that we love. Pastor Roderick, welcome to Real Life.
Wow, it's great to be here. Thank you.
Boy, do we need help.
We all need help. So that's where we got to start. Everybody needs help, Amy.
Everybody. So why Cover Him?
So Cover Him was really born out of the questions that women were asking. I wrote a book called Cover Her, which was for men, and the ladies started reading it. And they said, well, Pastor, what about us? What are we supposed to do? How are we supposed to respond to our husbands? And they said, men don't tell us what they're thinking or what they're feeling or what their needs are.
Right. So now we're just supposed to read their minds, right?
Yeah.
So now you've given us sort of an instruction manual, really detailed, really thorough. And I mean, even reading through it, you really got in all of my business.
Well, coaching is in my DNA.
Good.
And I think the simpler we can make things, the more effective people can be. Mm-hmm. And so I went and interviewed guys, right? Guys that I've walked with, men that I've coached, men from my years with the Ravens. Mm-hmm. And I said, what do you need your wife, your significant other, to understand about you and to get? And as they began to list things, I saw some common threads, and that became the content of the book.
Okay, so just for clarity, 14 years with the Baltimore Ravens as the chaplain, which you know you're in Steeler Nation, so yes, we still...
Go Ravens.
There is respect, man. Yeah, especially with those two Super Bowl rings that you have on. I don't know if you got a shot of those, but those things are fierce. That's just amazing. So you did learn a lot about men and their needs. Let's start with chapter one, affirm him.
Amy, listen, every man needs affirmation. And sometimes women don't think so. Mm-hmm. Because if you're married to a strong guy, a strong-willed guy, right, who gets up, he goes to work every day, he does the things that are necessary, you can easily think he's got it beat. But every man goes out into the real world and he has to face devils and demons.
Right.
He's got to deal with opposition. Any good man who's trying to carry his weight of responsibility faces opposition. And I tell ladies, if you will blow the wind of affirmation under his wings, if you will remind him that you appreciate him, that he's doing a great job.
Yes.
Someone once said that what gets celebrated gets repeated.
Ooh.
So if you celebrate him, he's going to likely do it again and continue to do it because he sees that you affirm those things in him. Now, it's not that women don't need affirmation. I think we all need it. But I think there's a particular need that men have for it. And it's a secret that if women will employ it, they will see their man become more of who God created him to be.
Okay, I need some examples of affirmation. Yes. You know, to the woman who's struggling, she's like totally annoyed right now with her spouse. And it's been a good while she's been annoyed, you know, and like steam's coming out of her ears. How do I switch that to affirming him, like to changing that negative to positive?
Listen, a broke clock is right at least once a day. Okay.
That's good.
So even if the guy's not all he should be, he's been getting on your nerves. I say to ladies, listen, if you just find the good thing that's working, because everybody's doing something that can be affirmed. So I know I get on my wife's nerves, right? We've been married, Sherry and I, for almost 29 years. She's been an amazing spouse. The toughest moment in my week is either before I preach or just after I preach. And when I come down out of the pulpit, I don't care who's, you know, how many people get saved and all that. When she says to me, thank you for preaching that word. That was a good word.
Yes.
That's all I need.
Yes.
I can go to the next service and I can get through. You understand?
Yeah.
It blows wind under my wings.
Right.
And so it makes a difference.
Oh, good. Because I said that yesterday to my husband.
Good
I said,
job.
You are the best preacher. He was like, It is weird how that works.
I'm telling you. You
literally can change your marriage relationship and that vibe in your home by just finding the good in them.
Listen, you're so right. That man, he doesn't even know how much he needs it. And even when he's sort of veering off and he's not who he should be, you can help change his course because a word of affirmation is a change in attitude.
Yeah.
And he'll be like, whoa, where did that come from? And now all of a sudden he's awakened and he says, well, she really does see something good in me.
Yeah.
And then I believe he will want to start stepping into that.
And he'll live up to that.
That's right.
So awesome. Okay. So how many women are trying to change their man, which we're even going to talk about later, but you said this in your chapter on pray for him. You said, ladies, sometimes you can't talk a man into change. Bummer. We thought we could. You can't convince him against his will. Even the thing that you're trying to convince him of, if it's good for him, but your prayers have the ability to turn the lights on for him when he can't see the danger ahead.
Listen, there is such supernatural power in prayer.
Now,
many of the women I know, no disrespect at all, they like to try to talk their men into things.
To get
them going in certain directions.
Yes.
And they think that it's, because women can talk to one another.
Yes.
And it's part of how you relate.
Mm-hmm.
But most men, after a while, don't want to hear the chatter of a woman trying to point them in the right direction, even when the woman is right. Because a lot of times you're right, but we can't hear it.
Right.
And so what I say to women is, listen,
so good.
If you will just go and pray. Again, my wife does this all the time. I'll bring to her a great idea. Baby, I think we should do X, Y, and Z. And sometimes she won't say a word. She'll just go, really? She doesn't say anything. She just looks at me, Now, I know when she says, all right, I'm in trouble. She doesn't say anything. She goes and she prays. And then in a week, 2 weeks later, I'll come back to her and say, you know what? That idea I shared with you, that was the most ridiculous idea. She goes, right? Because she was praying.
I love that.
And it changes things. It gives perspective.
Yes.
And it's one of the amazing ways that a woman can support her man. Get on your knees, right? And watch God. The Bible says that the king's heart is in the Lord's hand.
Yes.
And he directs it like a water course wherever he pleases.
Because we're not the Holy Spirit. That's like an aha moment for women, that we're not the Holy Spirit.
That's it.
And that we can't, by talking and nagging, change him or the situation or our marriage.
You have to depend more on God than you depend on you.
Yeah.
That's the key. If you want to see change, believe God, right? Believe that God is able. He's able to get a hold of that man's heart. And it's not that the things a woman wants are wrong. Mm-hmm. It's just that the methodology can be ineffective. And when you really need to see change in a man's life, God is the answer to that change.
Yeah. Okay. So you wrote this book. It's Valentine's week. Valentine's Day is this Friday and you're writing about marriage and relationships. Tell me one thing in this book that this will help marriages right now.
It's Valentine's. If you go to the respect chapter, that's my,
go-to.
ECT.
Find out what
you know.
Yeah.
Right.
Respect him.
I'm telling you, men are crying out for respect.
Wow.
And respect is not something you simply say to a man. It's something you demonstrate to a man.
Mm.
We are wired for respect. Mm. So I tell women all over the country, listen, when you begin to respect him, he'll feel it. He'll know it.
Mm-hmm.
It'll be so visceral that he'll be able to feel it. You won't even have to say, I'm trying to do this. He will feel it, and it will change the dynamics of your relationship.
Okay, what is that feeling? What do I need to do? What does that look like? You know, I have no idea. You know, I'm going to have to look up the word respect. How do I show it? How do I follow through with this?
I think it is acts of deference.
Mm.
Right? So, honey, if this is the direction you want to go in, I'll follow you. Right. And we're not talking about things that are dangerous or that are harmful. We're talking about those things that give him room to lead.
Yes.
Right. Honey, what would you like to do about this?
Mm-hmm.
Right. Have your idea. You can present that. I think he will respect. I think most men appreciate that. I want my wife's perspective.
Mm-hmm.
But when she says to me, honey, you're the man of the house. So however you want to go about this, I'm with you. I mean, something rises up in me. I'm like, oh, I better get this right.
Yes.
I want to rise to that challenge. And so this Valentine's Day, if a woman can posture herself, just the simple words, you're the man of this household.
Wow.
You're the leader. will go a long way.
Yeah, because God designed the marriage and the family unit. And if ever there was an attack on marriages yes. and couples, it is now. We need the couples, the men and women of God, to stick together, to be unified, yes. to yeah. walk in this respect and this affirmation, and to pray for them, yeah. and so many other great, great tips. Thank you so much for coming to Real Life. We're going to hear more from you in just a minute, Pastor Roderick. So, so good, so rich.